PowerSchool is my learning management system and student information system. Stay tuned at the end of the show to learn about an upcoming webinar about measuring what matters. It's college admissions time. So if you haven't already sent in that application for those seniors, if you have a junior student, you're starting to think about it now. So today we have an author who helps students with college admissions. So today's show is episode 239, College Admissions Tips and How-Tos for Parents and Teachers.
The 10-Minute Teacher Podcast with Vicki Davis. Every weekday, you'll learn powerful, practical ways to be a more remarkable teacher today.
Today, we're talking with Jennifer Aquino, the author of the International Family Guide to U.S. University Admissions. Jennifer, where do we start? I mean, there's all kinds of books that say, okay, have a good SAT, have this, have that. But is that the right place to start when we're talking about college admissions with our kids?
Vicki, this is the question, right? This is why I also wrote the book, because every family, every student would come to me and say, where do we start? There's really not a one word answer for that, but there is a place to start, and that's really with the child, him or herself, and helping him or helping her discover and embrace who she really is, building up her confidences, helping her take risks, and understanding who this person is, championing that, and bringing that through to the applications.
But you know, it's so tough. So I have two, one's graduated from college, one is in college, and I have one in high school. You know, there are certain things that if the students don't have a certain grade level, if they don't have certain SATs, some of those choices are kind of eliminated, aren't they?
Well, here's the way that I look at it, and this also goes along with how admissions works in the U.S. How many universities do we have in the U.S., right? There's over 3,500 four-year degree-granting institutions in the U.S. There is a fit for every student. The problem that we face is that we don't start at the right starting block. So we're always starting, putting pressure on the students with the grades and these crazy standardized tests, right? Instead of starting with, who are you? Who are you? What do you love to do? What are you afraid of? What are challenges for you? What do you want to try in life? What are you proud of yourself for? And really helping the student understand who she is so that she can build up her own self-confidence, start to embrace her own self, and realize where her strengths are and obviously her weaknesses, where they lie as well, because we all have them. And then looking for the universities and colleges that fit that very specific student.
You make me think about a student who I have who just started an excellent school, Savannah College of Art and Design, but we actually had some of these conversations in eighth and ninth grade. You know, she was just beating herself up. I want to go to a great college. I want to go to a great college. And I remember the conversation we had. And I said, okay, what if you end up in art school? How important is math? And she had a good math grade, but honestly, admissions in her math scores weren't as important as her portfolio for that college.
Right. Right. Absolutely. You're absolutely right. And going back to what you just said, Vicki, of, you know, she wants to go to a great college, but we have to sort of, we've got to dig down deep of what does that mean? What does a great college mean for Iski Frowski, for every single different individual who exists on this planet, child who exists on this planet? There is a great college because for that individual person, because that means it's a fit for them, right? So a great college is not one that comes out on the rankings or one that we see everybody wearing the sweatshirts of. That's a great college for several students, but not for every student. A great university, a fabulous university, is one that fits, like you're talking about your student, that fits her, that's going to embrace her, her talents, her strengths, and also support her and her future and help her become a success, whatever success means in her mind and in her life.
Yeah, and I actually went to Georgia Tech, which two of my children go. Oh. But I went there in the 80s when there weren't many women there. So a lot, I can't tell you how many people tried to convince me not to go there. And I'm like, are you trying to tell me not to go there because I'm a woman? Mm. Or you just can't picture women in technology? So, Jennifer, let's talk about what are some common mistakes that parents and teachers make when trying to help kids with the college admissions process?
I think one of the first, well, it's very different, huh? They're very different when we talk about the mistakes parents make and the mistakes that teachers make. So from my experience. So I think one of the mistakes that parents make, and I say this with 100% of respect, is this idea or this notion that a recognized university, again, walking down the street where I am right now in New York and seeing that university on someone's sweatshirt and recognizing that, that means it's a good university for my son or my daughter. That's not the case, right? We're talking about fit. Universities select the students to attend their university based on fit. Sure, it's based on grades and in some cases based on standardized testing, but it's based on fit. As you know, Vicky, every university has its own character, has its own personality, and they're looking for students who are going to fit into that personality, right? And you mentioned mistakes that teachers make. I think that mistakes that teachers perhaps might make are falling into that, the standard that we consider what is needed for U.S. university admissions of, okay, so how are your grades? How are your test scores? Have you filled out your applications? Sort of the procedural steps, instead of looking at each student as the individual self and helping her, again, embrace who she is, build up her confidence and say, have you looked at such and such university or have you considered somewhere else? I think teachers are probably one of the best resources for students in terms of helping them, not necessarily through the process of that, because that goes to the guidance counselor and so on, but my students look up to their teachers like no one else. I mean, so these are their mentors. So when I have a student tell me, well, I had my teacher today suggest a university to me. She knows the university well. She thought it could be a fit. They are so much more inclined to research that institution, to try to get to know that institution because they trust the teacher. And the teacher knows them so well. So obviously, not asking teachers to understand what every 3,500 universities, their different personalities and criteria and admissions standards are. But to really have a conversation with the student, I think that's really, really, really helpful of saying, where are you thinking of going? Why would you go there? Why does that interest you? To help them start to think about, yeah, why am I thinking that? Is it because it just falls on the list and I just see someone with a sweatshirt or it falls on the rankings or my parents told me or my social network is telling me I should apply there? Or is it because I can really defend my fit and say, this is the right university for me?
So when do you start having those conversations? What age or grade?
Great question. It's a great question. So I tend to work with students on the building confidence, trying new things, taking new risks, embracing who they are in 9th and 10th grade. Okay, so that's 10th and 11th grade in the British system. The process begins in the penultimate year. In my view, starting the process before that, I think is far too early. When I say process, that means developing their list, starting to do standardized tests, starting to fill out applications. I don't like them to do that prior to the penultimate year in secondary school or high school, because I think it locks them in and it doesn't allow them to keep their mind open and allow them to be okay to change. And they are going to change, as you know, as a teacher. But I think in 9th and 10th grade, there are things that they should be preparing for university admissions. But that's really about the self. And that's that self-evaluation and that self-embrace.
You know, I've just found having my 9th and 10th graders create resumes and having different sections for, you know, your experiences, your honors. And the kids will come up and they'll say, I don't have anything in this section. And I'll say, oh, what do you need to do that? So they can make educated decisions about what they're going to do in high school.
It's great that you're doing that, Vicky. And I mentioned this in my book too. There are some adults who say, well, kids shouldn't have CVs. I'm a big proponent of kids having CVs or resumes. I think it helps them take a look, just like you said with your example, take a look at, wow, maybe I need to try this, or maybe I do need to do something new, or maybe I'm not working as hard in my classes as I should be. But I think it gives a nice snapshot. And I think that's a great way to start with them too.
So Jennifer, as we finish up, give us a 30-second pep talk on helping every child find that fit for a college.
Let's help our students build confidence in themselves by trying new things, taking new risks, learning what it is to fail at something, learning what it is to succeed at something, and really encouraging them to embrace who they are, not who we want them to be or who their parents want them to be or who their friends want them to be, but to really embrace who they are, because that is what will come through in a solid and winning application, them being able to express themselves and express how they are a fit for their universities that they're applying to.
Jennifer's given us such great advice, teachers. And one of the questions I always ask students when they sit down and say, you know, what should I write for my college application, or what should I write for, you know, my valedictory speech, is I always say, what is it about you that makes you special? If you had, you know, a minute in an elevator to tell somebody something that really made you different and unique, what would you talk about? Because you don't want the kids to be turning in something that 10,000 other students could write. There's always a story. Every child has a story of something they've overcome.
Exactly.
On January 31st, join a free webinar about preparing students for success and measuring what matters. Jared Cotton, a superintendent from Virginia, will be sharing on that webinar. Just go to coolcatteacher.com/what matters and learn more. I use and enjoy the PowerSchool Learning Management System to help blend my classroom and measure what matters. Check out PowerSchool and their unified classroom today.
Thank you for listening to the 10-Minute Teacher Podcast. You can download the show notes and see the archive at coolcatteacher.com/podcast. Never stop learning.